Well, hi there. I'm Matt Adams with Loop, and I'm really excited today because we're going to be starting off a new video series on using Git with PLCs, specifically with Automation Studio. Now, you've probably heard of Git. It's the world's most popular version control tool, and we use it here at Loop on all of our projects. Now, unfortunately, the industrial automation space hasn't really had that same kind of uptake that the rest of the software engineering disciplines have, and I'm hoping to change that by going through a couple of tutorials to specifically show you what the workflow would look like in the world of PLC development. So what I have is a project that I'm going to make a couple of changes to, save those changes as a commit, and then push those up to a repository. And if some of those phrases are a little bit new to you, they won't be in just a couple of minutes. So the project here is just a start and a stop button that are connected to a contactor that's running this conveyor belt. On this input card here, a start and stop button are mapped to these digital inputs, and on this output card, the conveyor motor contactor is connected to this digital output. And what we're going to do is change this project to add a stack light so that people on the other end of the conveyor can see if the conveyor is running by seeing either a green light when it's running or a red light when it's stopped. To make the change to this project, there's really only three steps. First, we're going to declare a couple of variables, stack light red and stack light green. And then we're going to connect those variables to some digital outputs, number 2 and 3. And finally, we're going to modify our code to control stack light red and stack light green. Now I'm going to move over to SourceTree, which is my Git client. One of Git's primary functions is tracking changes, and we just made three of them in our project, and it looks like Git has seen that these three files were changed. Here we see that the global variables were changed when we added the two stack lights, and these two I/O mappings were added as well, and finally we added these two lines to our program. Now combined, these all make a really nice feature change to my program, and we're going to save this collection of changes together in something that we call a commit. With every commit you create, you also create a message along with it so you know what the commit will do when you check it out. So I'm going to stage all of these changes here and create this commit. Now this commit is saved to something called a repository. And if a commit is a collection of changes, then a repository is sort of like a timeline record of commits. So let's make some more changes to our project and expand our repository commit timeline with another commit. If you were a careful observer, I did something that I promised would never actually happen in real life. I introduced a bug into my code. Not only did I map the red stack light to the start command, I never turned either stack light off. So let me squash this bug by switching the colors and turning the correct one off. Now that I've made this change, we can open up my Git client, and sure enough, these changes were noticed. I effectively removed a couple of lines highlighted in pink and added a couple of lines that are highlighted in green. I'll go ahead and create a commit message, stage this changed file, and make my commit. Now when we switch back to the repository history, we can see that another commit has been added to this repository timeline, but my previous one still remains. Now let's say for some reason you wanted to see this bug and check it out for yourself. There's a command for that aptly called checkout. I'll right-click on a commit and then select checkout. This restores the exact code base that was present when that commit was made. And when I move into Automation Studio, it's smart enough to know that the files were changed outside the editor, inside Git, and it asks if I want to reload this code. When I hit yes to all, you can see this buggy code in all of its glory that I just checked out. Fortunately, going back to my bug-free commit is just as easy as opening up my Git client and double-clicking on the corrected commit, which will perform a checkout automatically. Back in Automation Studio, my bugs are fixed, and I'm ready to control conveyors and stack lights like a superhero with my trusty sidekick. Git.